Dobrý den. Hello for Monday, August 11th. Hey, as a note, it's that time of year again. We will probably have a video for Tuesday, but then we're off for a week and we'll be back probably on the 21st, though may pop into the chat room from time to time. This is the Dow 15, no, this is the 60-minute chart. We're running our room on the 15-minute. Thought we'd just show the 60-minute here. Show that we've got resistance coming up. All this area over here towards the late part of June should offer some resistance, not far overhead, as you can see, about 11,800. So it may be that rise is going to be up there. Now, if it pulls back to the same level that it was recently, you can see here was resistance, over here was resistance. So as it pulls back this time, this should be support. That may be a buy, but be careful in there. Because the market, as you know, has been reversing quite a bit. We have here the moving averages on the 60-minute chart are crossing. If they do cross, that's bullish, of course, and just the meeting of them does cause this volatility. But even if we do break above these areas, we got several other areas ahead as resistance on the S&P 500, also 60-minute chart, as you can see. Of course, very similar pattern. Many of the stocks are in each of these indexes, of course, and it did break above the June high of 1,291, up about 5 points from there. Now it has resistance just overhead, as you can see up here. This was support back in June, and now this should become resistance as well. We don't have shown here, and this wouldn't, I don't know how it translates onto the 60-minute chart. But on the daily, the 55-day moving average, not exponential, but just moving average, is at about 1305. And that may be an important number. Quite often, they rally up to it. If it fails, it could be dropping down. That's to watch. But this chart right now looks pretty bullish, but we've seen that before. Now, in RSI on the 60-minute is not yet overbought, and on stochastics, it's just about 94 at the moment on Russell. Of course, this has been the better than those because it fell much less, and it's almost back up to, we can see it's almost up to a June high. That's done very well, and its pullback to 726 may find support, so you can watch that for possible re-entries on it, because if it breaks there, then of course it's probably going back down to test this bottom trend line once again, or at least even the 718, which is on the 60-minute chart. It's 50 period EMA. For additions to the watch list, we have quite a few, and several of these we are watching on Friday as the markets moved. And because of the rally, some broke out and some broke out and pulled back, but I don't think in this case that it's necessarily peaks. You know, quite often when they pull back and then they give it up, this means they're going to start a downtrend again. I think some of that was a Friday profit taking. Well, it doesn't matter the reason. It just looks like that case because we've got increase in volume, as you can see. So I would say LLNW, if we've got a run rate of volume, which you can determine if when it moves back above 420 once again, even though it's close to it right now, you'll have to be cautious for that. But if it pulls above it and then come back down into this area, that could be a buy. It's high on Friday was 451, so that possible entry as well if the volume run rate is strong. GNK, we got several shorts, and of course because of the strong rally on Friday, a lot of these bounce. But if they bounce on lower volume, then that does not negate the short possibility. So we've got GNK, as you can see, on Thursday high volume, well over 2 million, 2.3 million, and then not even 1 million on Friday on the bounce. So if this pulls back again and drops below 51, GNK looks like it's short. ACN, a long position over this 4204. It's a pretty good setup. Nice green volume days show that they were stronger going up than the pullbacks coming down. Strong on Thursday, a little weaker on Friday, but above 4204, ACN looks like a long. How about some ICE? Now this one, the volume wasn't great on Friday, less on Friday than it was on the pullback on Thursday. So as it's shaping up here, it still looks like a possible short under 80.20. This could also be kind of an inverted cup and handle shaping up. I wouldn't play it long. Some could over this 90 area if volume comes in. It, particularly if you like to scalp, and this one is a popular scalper because it can move several dollars, you know, quickly. So you could watch it here if you like to play those, but this is set up as a short under 80-20 on ice. OFC, this one broke above this original line around 40-40, and it closed at 40-06. And I'm looking now, the high was 40-40. So I think it's a pretty bullish setup, but you can see this one has pretty wide swings here. But it does have a golden cross with the stronger, the 200 period under the 50 period. You want the longer period under. That's bullish. So it goes above the high of 40-40 so long, but once again, this is kind of a volatile stock on OFC. PWR, this one we are watching, but we really like this chart. We like that it gapped up on good volume, not just the first day, but the second day as well, and all this pullback was low volume. And then it started having strong volume once again. We hoped that it would hold in here and keep till Monday, but of course it didn't. It broke out, which happens quite often. It was up 5%, so it's had a pretty good move. But we show it because it may be a continuation, but preferably it will pull back, and then you'll get a second chance at it. So if you don't like that kind that have already broken, then don't play that one. Okay, we've got another short, and that's in Sina. And Sina's been, over the years, this has been a great one. But right now, this kind of looks like an inverted cup and handle. It's a possibility that's the case. It's still bullish insofar as the moving averages, EMAs. We still have the 200 underneath the 50. But this would, of course, cross eventually if this does drop. Anyway, it could be a bounce, of course, but this high volume is one key. When this has high volume, there could be exhaustion selling. Maybe they're all done. But still, and it does have this support over here on the left, but it's got a long green candle, which is probably going to provide no real support, is quite often the case. Anyway, if Sina drops under 39.20, or if you prefer around number 39 exactly, but under 39.20, it looks like a short on SINA. Keep tight stops on those, and of course, we've got a volatile market. Don't want to be short in a short squeeze. STV under $10, round number $10, quite often worked. Now this gap down, then had to move back up. Some people may short if it moves back up again. I think in this case, well, I would wait until under 10. If it breaks under 10, it's liable to fall because this 10, these round numbers tend to work that way. But anyway, that's the setup on STV. Then we've got YGE. This is a short as well. We had this one also set up, actually, I think on Thursday night after the close. We saw this one, thought maybe this would be good in Friday, but it was too late to post. So it did take its first short position at this point here, but it dropped only 3%. But I think the next one on YGE would be under 14.20 to $14 even, and then you can see we've got support down here at 13.15 to 13.26. But I think under 14.20, we may have a short shot at YGE. And then lastly, we've got INTU. This one has had quite a run from this 26 up to 29.87, meaning it's pretty straight up. So if it does break out and you're to play this over this 30.06 area, use caution because it's really kind of vertical. Much better if it drops down in here, goes sideways for a while, and then we'll have a breakout. We'd much prefer that. So if you play these that look a little risky, but you still want to play them, just lower your position size on them or sell more on the first pop-up. Anyway, that's what we've got for editions for a Monday. Thanks a lot for coming by the site. I hope you have a great trading day, the start of the week, and I think we'll be back in the morning with some more new ideas for you. Thanks. Bye-bye.